Hello friends, I am Ankur Patel and let me tell you what is PHP. PHP is a programming language. Basically, it is useful for web application development. And it is also called open source language and a scripting language. So let's try to understand each and every definition of PHP. So PHP is mainly useful for web application development, right? So you know, majority of the time nowadays you develop applications for web only. Desktop applications are you know, getting developed, but rarely. You know, majority of software industry is moving towards web application development. So for web, PHP is a very easy to understand and easy to learn programming language. Now it is a programming language, and it was started, the development of the language was started between 1993 to 1995. The founder of this language is Rasmus. He started this PHP programming language as a CGI script using C programming. So the PHP language base is C and C++ programming language. Many of the PHP programmers also don't know that using which language this PHP language itself is created. The answer is C and C++. And it is open source programming language. It means the source code of PHP language is available, and the source code is written using C and C++. You can download the whole source code of PHP language from its official website called php.net. Now it is important to understand that whenever it's open source, it's free. So you can download the source code, you can modify and you can use it in your own way. But you have to understand that free is not always open source. For example, if I create a program in C language, so you know, the source code is written using .c extension, and we compile the source code and create the executable out of it. So if I give the executable free of charge, but if I don't give the source code to people, then it is free, but the source code is not open, right? The source code is still with the writer, with the coder who created this code. So it is not open source. So free is not always open source, but whenever it's open source, it is free. So PHP is an open source programming language, mainly useful for web application development. The company which is behind this programming language is Zend. You can visit zend.com. It is the company which is promoted by the founders of this PHP programming language. They have their own editors, the framework and so on. So Zend is the company which is behind this PHP language, same like Microsoft is behind .NET framework. Same way, PHP, for PHP language, Zend is the company. So now you understand that PHP is a open source language. This is for mainly web application development, and the base is written using C and C++. Now another term which people use for PHP programming language is it's a scripting language. Now you have to understand the difference between normal programming language and scripting language. Many programmers don't have a real good idea why it's a scripting language. See, whenever it's a scripting language, it is interpreted language. See, there are two kind of programming languages. One is compiled language, and in another one is interpreted language. In interpreted language, the execution happens line by line, and there is no executable getting created when it's a scripting language. So let's say in C programming language, we write the source code, we compile and we create the executable out of it. In scripting language, for example PHP, there is no exe getting created. Whenever you want to execute the program, you need the source code to execute it. and line by line execution happens. So that is the difference between normal programming language and scripting language. Like if you have heard about JavaScript, right? So in JavaScript there is no exe getting created. The JavaScript code is within the HTML code, and that gets executed when the page loads within the browser, right? So browser executes the JavaScript code and you need the source code to execute it. And another difference which you have to understand is regarding the variable. So in C, can you declare the variable without the data type? So can you write I equal to 0? You cannot, right? You have to say integer I, int I equal to 0. Without defining the data type, you cannot use the variable. But in scripting language, it is possible. Without defining the data type, you can use the variable. In PHP, any variable starts with the dollar sign. So you can say dollar I equal to 10, right? And you can start using the variable. You don't need to define that it is integer dollar I equal to 10. But that doesn't mean that in PHP there is no data type. Of course, there are data types available, and PHP, when we define the variable, depending upon the value, it assign the data type to the variable. So if I say dollar I equal to 10, so by looking at the value, you know that it's an integer type of value. So dollar I data type is integer, right? But it is assigned by language itself to the variable, right? As a programmer, you are not defining the data type to the variable. So in short, these are the two major differences between programming language and scripting language, and that you have to know when it's a scripting language. Now PHP, if you go to php.net website and if you read the official definition and even the full form, you also have to know the full name of PHP. The full name is PHP Hypertext Preprocessor. The first P is for PHP, and then H for hypertext, and last P is for preprocessor. So that way it is also considered as recursive acronym, because the P itself is PHP and then hypertext preprocessor. Earlier the full name of PHP was personal homepage, and then people used to call it professional homepage also. But whatever name you call it nowadays is PHP. It stands for PHP Hypertext Preprocessor. So basically it is useful with the HTML, and you can embed your PHP code anywhere in the HTML. So you write the PHP code, and you write HTML code and PHP code intermittently or using any mix, you can write it down. Generally you give the extension .php to the file name where you have written PHP code. While learning and understanding PHP, you also have to understand the overall platform, which is called LAMP or WAN. LAMP, if we call it, then L stands for Linux, A for Apache, M for MySQL, and P for PHP. Actually, the last P is not only for PHP, but Python and Perl also, because those two other languages are also open source. So LAMP is considered as a open source application platform, application development platform. Any machine, you need the operating system first. So Linux is the preferred operating system for all production web application. Then you need a web server. So Apache is the web server which you can use it. There are other web servers also available. For example, Microsoft IIS is also available, but Apache is open source. Then database, it's not necessary to use MySQL database only with PHP. PHP supports many other databases, but the preferred choice is MySQL. It is also open source. And now it is MySQL was a separate company, but it's taken over by Oracle, so now it's Oracle MySQL. And PHP, P for PHP, as well as Perl and Python. So the overall platform is LAMP. If you are using Windows as operating system, then it is considered as WEM. Now when you are doing the development on Windows, majority of the time whatever you have created on Windows, same code will be useful and applicable on Linux platform also. I would say 90 to 95%, but some percentage, let's say 5% code you have to change for the sake of folder and file path, because it's different in Linux compared to Windows. But most of the code will run as it is in Linux environment, even if you have created in Windows environment. There are a couple of setups available for PHP development, called XAMPP or WAMP server or Uniform server. Basically those setups are the combination of Apache, MySQL, PHP, as well as some other utilities like PHP, MyAdmin and so on. So you can easily download this kind of setups from internet and install it within 2-3 minutes and you run it. And whatever PHP files you create, that you have to put in the base folder of Apache, which is generally htdocs or www folder. So I hope you have got brief introduction of what PHP is and what is the environment to develop PHP applications. Nowadays one of the biggest success of PHP MySQL development platform is Facebook itself, right? Facebook is created using PHP MySQL. So that itself justifies that it's a very robust platform. One thing I forgot to mention, that PHP is very powerful and it started in 1993-1995, so now it's almost more than 18-20 years, so it's quite mature and powerful programming language, which was designed and developed specifically for web application development. So I hope you got good idea what PHP programming language is. If you have any further question, you can visit phpmysqltrainer.com and see some more videos related to PHP programming. Thank you very much.